This is Kat with Hair Locks, and I'm here today to show you how to actually utilize the wefts and lock them in using cylinders. So there's no braiding necessary and there's no sewing. I'm here with my model Jamie, and I'm actually going to put in a half head. One thing that's, blah, blah, blah. Let's do it again. One thing that's great about working with these wefts and really utilizing them and locking them in is, number one, it's very unabrasive. And on top of that, it's very quick. So this is great for photo shoots, brides, anybody that you really want to put these in really fast, get a nice big wow factor, and then drop them out just as quick. So I'm going to be working with the 24-inch hair today, and it came in the straight color number one. And as you can tell, I did some custom coloring on it to match Jamie's hair earlier. Very difficult to get that dark color off, so we're gonna just work with it today. What we're also going to be using with these wefts to put them in with cylinders is you are gonna work with a bundle of I-tip hair as well. If you only crimp down the cylinder onto the weft itself, it's gonna be very, very difficult to remove. So it's better when you can actually install an I-tip extension as well, so that way it's easier to open up the cylinder for very quick removal. Now, I've already prepped the hair. Like I said, I've already colored it and done a custom color for Jamie. The other thing that I've done is I have actually taken the wefts and doubled and tripled them up just to make them a little bit thicker, just to customize them for what I'm doing. Now, if you want a finer or thinner section, if your client has finer or thinner hair, go ahead and use the thinner sections. It's absolutely fine. But what we're doing is we're really utilizing as much of the hair as possible and just get a big bang really quickly as that half head install. And I've just doubled them up and kind of tied them together. That way, when I install them, I'll get a nice lock of hair. And you can also see at the top, I left the color a little bit lighter. That way, when Jamie's regrowth grows out, because I know she's closer to around a level 7, level 6, when it grows away from her scalp, it's gonna blend in a little bit more. However, again, you're more than welcome to customize this per client, however you see fit. It was really easy to actually color these because it's all in a weft. So that's one of the great things about coloring when you've got a chain of hair, is it's actually very quick to do your custom colors for your clients. So I've got my two sections ready to go for Jamie's hair. I also have my cylinders threaded up. So let's get started. Ta-da! Now I'm gonna be installing two separate wefts today. I've got one that's about this size, I've got another one that's a little bit bigger, a little bit thicker, just to really thicken up her occipital bone area. Now it's up to you whether you would like to have your client hold it and anchor it while you lock it in, or you can use clips to lock it in. Either way, it's up to you. Jamie is a very helpful assistant, so what I'm gonna have her do is I'm just gonna have her hold it for me. That way we don't get too much movement and the weft will stay nice and tight to her head, so I can make sure that our installation is nice and tight and we don't have too much movement. So the first thing I'm gonna do is just measure, make sure that what I've already done is gonna fit and it looks good. I'm not going all the way out to the outer area because I wanna make sure if she decides to pull her hair back, you're not gonna see any of the seams. I'm gonna hold this up. Now I'm gonna have Jamie come on in and she's just gonna hold either side for me. There we go, pinching down. She's got a hold of it. Let me see, let me just move this up. You're good. We're good to go. Now Jamie's holding either side. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create my anchors in the middle. All you have to do is grab a very small section of the natural hair from the top. You're also gonna grab a very small section of the natural hair from underneath. And make sure that you're not grabbing too much hair, because if you grab too much hair and you over-direct too much, it's gonna be difficult to fit all of this in with your cylinder as well. So I'm gonna pinch a little bit of the natural hair from above. I'm grabbing a little bit of our natural hair from underneath to create that anchor, as you can see. It's not too deep, it's not too much hair, because she needs to come in and get these maintenance. And it really is preference on when you want to come and get these done. As they start to get a little bit looser, they start to move around a little bit more, that's when you want to come back in. And make sure you don't grab too much of the natural hair, because if you do, once you try to pull this through the cylinder, you don't forget you have to wedge an extension in as well. So I'm going to slide that cylinder on. I'm gonna put my extension in. Make sure you don't have any crosshairs. And then I'm gonna crimp down nice and tight, 1, 2, 3. That's it. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make sure that I do a couple of anchors in the middle where tension can create. And you can just pull that natural hair down just in case you get that little bubble and that rat. Grab a little bit from underneath. Bring the two together. And we're gonna do the same motion right next to each other, side by side. The closer your cylinders are, the more anchored that area will be. And the most important areas are gonna be your middle and then your sides. And then you can fill in with your extensions in between. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do my anchor in the middle, I'm gonna do my anchors on the sides, and then I'm gonna do a couple of extensions just in between just to make sure it stays close to the scalp. Now we finished our first weft just at that kind of nape area, and you can see the kind of thickness that we're getting right away. Now, if this was just for a quick curl or maybe just one specific photo, this might be enough. But what we're gonna do is we're also gonna add in a second weft and add that extra thickness, again, right just at that occipital bone area, still curving up. That way, if she decides to pull her hair into a ponytail, it'll still be comfortable. Now I've got her sectioned off for our next weft, and as you can see, it's just at that midsection in her head. Now I've measured it again just to make sure that I'm at the right place and the right positioning. I'm gonna have Jamie hold those ends for me. And again, same exact idea that I did on the first one. I'm gonna put my three anchor cylinders in the middle with my I-tip extensions. I'm gonna do my three anchors in the outsides, and then I'm gonna fill in just a couple on the inside. Now, depending on how long you want this to stay in, you can either put multiple extensions in between your anchors, or you can use very minimal. Doesn't matter, just depends on what your time frame looks like and how long she wants to keep this in for. One thing I will say though is, the most important part, even if you only put your three anchor cylinders here and your three on the outsides, it is so important to put those anchors in. Otherwise, it's just gonna be too heavy and it can drag on the head. All right, so we're gonna get started on our next weft. So we're back and we finished our second weft on Jamie's head. And as you can see, we've got our three anchors in the middle, and then we've got a couple of I-tips on either side just to make sure that it's gonna stay steady and secure. I'm gonna let down her hair, and you can see the density that it created and that new weight line. We also have plenty of coverage of her natural hair. That way we can see it visually extends from where she started at her 16 inch hair, a little bit finer, a little bit thinner. And we've just got a nice full thick look. So I'm just going to curl her up and we'll come back to you with our finished look. So we finished Jamie's look. We just curled her a little bit. And what was really nice is Jamie has really long pieces in the front. So it really turned into a beautiful taper in the back. And it just kind of looks like framing around her face. Now, if you need to cut in and trim and frame the front, you're more than welcome to. I highly suggest that you use a razor or just slide cut with your shears. These wefts, when installed this way, can be reusable depending on the way that you take care of them. And I did use one package of the 24-inch hair, which is also 4 ounces. Now that's because I'm also doing a half of a head. Now if Jamie had shorter hair or thicker hair and she really wanted to extend it and really get that full length, maybe that full 24 inches out of it still, then I would probably use 2 packages. So be aware of that when you're doing your consultation and when you're trying to determine what you need for yourself. This is our final look. I hope you liked it and we'll see you next time.